What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today, I'm going to show you what's new in Enscape 3.1. Let's get started. Number 1. New Material Library. In Enscape 3.1, you will now have access to the new material library, which includes more than 240 materials that are ready to use. First, I'll open up the Enscape Material Editor. You can see that we don't have any materials in the scene yet. To use the new material library, you can click here and select Import from Enscape Material Library, or go down here and click on this new icon in the Enscape toolbar. You will see that the materials are organized in different categories, such as bricks, concrete, fabrics, glass, roads, tiles, wood, etc. Alternatively, you can easily type in a material that you want in this search bar here. To import a material, just select one or multiple materials that you like, and click here to import the selection. You can see that the materials are being added to the Enscape Material Editor, which also show up in the SketchUp Materials tray. Once imported, you can close the Enscape Material Library. Now you can apply these materials to your scene. Here you can see the bucket tool is not really working for me, so I'm going to use a plugin called Freddo Through Paint. And that looks better. And if you need more materials, just open the material library again and choose from the amazing materials that are ready to use. Also, if you really like a material, you can use the star icon to mark it as your favorite. So next time that you want to use it, you can go to the favorites section to find all of your favorite materials. As you can see, with the new Enscape Material Library, you don't have to invest so much time in searching and creating the right maps and materials for your scene. Enscape has given you more than 240 materials that are ready to use, and I'm sure they will keep adding more in the future. The cool thing about these materials is that, like any other materials, you can edit them however you want. For example, you can change the color, or you can make it more glossy, more bumpy, etc. Speaking of editing materials, if you haven't noticed, the Material Editor has been renewed. This takes me to number 2, Material Editor Overhaul. In Enscape 3.1, the Enscape Material Editor has been redesigned to provide a more intuitive experience. For example, you can now see small thumbnails of each map that are in a material right next to their name. If you hover your mouse over them, you will see a slightly bigger thumbnail. Clicking on any of the map will take you to its settings. These map tabs have also been improved. There's also a new material type that has been added, which is the self-illuminated material. This replaces the self-illumination checkbox in the previous version. And of course, the other types are still available to use. If you look at the icons to the right of each material in the materials list, you will see that these colors indicate the albedo color for the respective materials. Also, when changing materials types, you will see that the list updates the type indicator of that material. Pretty cool, huh? Another cool thing is that after you created a material for your scene, you can now export that Enscape material and save it in your personal library. Then next time, you can import it in and the maps are already in place and the material is ready to use. If you have multiple materials, you can click these three lines and select Batch Material Import. This is extremely helpful because whenever I finish a scene, I have lots of materials I want to save for future projects. This new feature will help make my workflow a lot faster. Number 3. Ray Traced Sun Shadows. In version 3.1, there is now Ray Traced Sun Shadows, which give you sharper and more accurate shadows. This feature is more noticeable when the shadow is sharper, so I will go to the Visual Settings, and in the Atmosphere tab, I'll increase the shadow sharpness to 100%. Now to turn on the Ray Traced Sun Shadows, I will go to the General Settings window, and in the Rendering tab, turn on Ray Traced Sun Shadows. Right away, you will see a huge difference. And when I move around the model, you can see that it works immediately after I stop moving. This also works when you export an image. Although the difference is not as big when you look at the shadows on the wall, but you can see a huge difference when we look at the plant. Number 4. NVIDIA DLSS support. You might also notice that Enscape now supports NVIDIA DLSS, also known as Deep Learning Super Sampling. This is a technology which uses AI super resolution to provide the highest frame rates at maximum graphics settings. With this new feature, you will get to experience higher quality on lower resolutions. Number 5. Panorama Gallery. There are also other new features such as the Panorama Gallery. To create a panorama, click on this button and Enscape will create a 360 image based on your current position. To upload it, go to the Enscape toolbar and click on Manage Uploads. Now you can select these panoramas and upload them to the cloud. Then you can use this link here to access your panoramas wherever you are. And those are the new features in Enscape 3.1. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, comment below and let me know which one is your favorite feature. Stay inspired guys, and I'll see you next time.